Welcome to Michael Stevens Living. Now last weekend, I baked some delicious buttery rolls for my great-grandson's wedding, and everyone loved them. But I didn't. I've got a problem with rolls. When things roll, they aren't always loyal. They roll and roll, and they don't come back to me. And I find that unacceptable. How dare you? That's why I created Dong Oats. Dong Oats will never leave you. If you push them away, they think better of leaving and decide to come back. Dong Oats love you, and I love you. Today, on Michael Stevens Living, I'm gonna show you how to make your own. The secret to Dong Oats is physics. There's no magic here, there's no trick, except for the fact that I'm using an opaque container so you can't see what's happening inside. But if I try to pull off the lid, ooh, you see that part of what's going on involves the power of rubber bands. What makes rubber bands work? Well, if you haven't seen Richard Feynman answer that question yet, you should. I've got a video linked down in the description below. But basically, rubber bands behave the way they do because they're made out of polymers. Long chains of atoms and molecules. And chain is pretty literal in this sense. If each link on this chain is an atom or a molecule, this is what that rubber looks like. But it doesn't form a straight line like this. And that's because at a microscopic and submicroscopic level, our world is constantly jiggling. If this is a polymer, if this is a chain of atoms and molecules, and it's just long enough to reach down to the table, what happens if I give it some thermal motion, if I give it a temperature above absolute zero? Well, it'll start kinking up. And as you can see, it's no longer reaching down to the table. It's shorter in the vertical direction because it's moving in the horizontal direction as well. If you wanted this chain to reach down to the table, you'd have to reach in and pull it straight down. You'd have to apply a force, but it would still be jiggling. And as soon as you let go, it would go back to jiggling and being all kinked up, and it would be shorter. That is exactly what happens in a rubber band. Now, just like with the chain, thermal motion has the effect of kinking up the polymers in the rubber band, shortening them. At this scale, the universe really is this busy. We're fortunate to not see a chaotic mess of vibration when we look around the universe. Instead, we see the stable general areas of jiggling that we call things. Okay, anyway, stretching a rubber band requires a force to work against this thermal bombardment. When the stretching force ceases, the thermal force, not resisted anymore, kinks the polymers back up and the band shortens again. Any action that forces the polymers to unkink against this jiggling and bombardment requires effort, work. But that work can then be done by the band when it's released. We're going to take advantage of this behavior of rubber polymers to create a can that rolls away and then comes back. Let's just start building, and as we build it, we'll see how it works. To make this really clear, I'm going to use a literally clear container. You could use any kind of bottle you wanted to. It just has to be strong enough to withstand the stretch of a rubber band and hold it in an extended state. The first thing I need to do is poke some holes in the lid and the bottom of the bottle. You could do this with any number of tools. You could use scissors, you could use an ice pick. I'm gonna use a drill, but whatever you do, please, please be careful. I don't want anyone getting hurt. I just want you to learn, and learning never hurts unless you want it to. Okay. So here goes the hole in the lid. Perfect. It doesn't have to be exactly in the center. That doesn't matter too much at all. Now, let's put a hole in the bottom of the bottle. Again, you don't need to worry too much about it being perfect. We just need it to be opposite the lid. Mm-hmm. Wonderful, beautiful. Okay, so now that we have a bottle with a hole through both ends, can you see me there? Probably not, I can barely see you, but trust me, this bottle now has a hole through it. We need to get out these tools I made earlier. I have a paper clip that I've straightened out and then made into a little hook shape. Then I also have this longer piece of stiff wire that I've also made a little hook with. I hope that's clear. You don't need to use these specific tools, I just find it really easy. Now, if you look up instructions online for how to make a device like this, they often recommend using a 9-volt battery because it's got pretty good weight to it. But 9-volt batteries are expensive, that's ridiculous. I have a more favored solution. This is actually how I built my first rollback bottle when I was like 8 or 9 years old. I hope I've been microwaving these long enough. Ooh, this is perfect. I have here 17 pennies. 17 pennies weigh about 45 grams, the same as a 9-volt battery. What I love about it is that pennies are denser than the battery, so you actually can use more of them. And I think we can get away with using a bit more. So there's 17. 17 pennies compared to a battery. Smaller volume here, larger volume here. Let's see how many more pennies I can get in there. I haven't prepared any more, but I could use some fresh. Some fresh pennies. Okay, here we go. Oh yeah, those are good. Those are nice, and I don't think it's gonna be a problem that they're raw. All right, so this is 17 more pennies, 45 more grams. I actually haven't tried 90 grams worth of weight. I wonder if this will be too much. Well, let's just use the same height as a battery. Good, good, good. Okay, so there we've got some pennies. About as high as the 9-volt battery. We're gonna tape these up into a nice solid roll. Just got some tape here. You can use duct tape. You can use transparent tape, whatever you want. So if I stack these up on the tape, and then roll them up like a little penny burrito. Ooh, love it. All right, let's just do a little bit of final securing. Good. Okay, now we get to use a rubber band. Once we've made our little penny burrito, we can introduce the rubber band. A rubber band like this will do. I'm gonna lay the rubber band across the penny. And I think separating the two, the top and the bottom sides, helps it stay in place. Because what we need is some more tape. And we're going to just tape this rubber band to the very top of the penny burrito. All right, so I've got both sides of the rubber band touching each other, not on top of each other. I think this helps them stick better because we don't want them stretching out of the way when we pull both ends of the rubber band. Okay, let's see. Make sure that's really secure. Make sure the pennies don't move back and forth or up and down on the rubber band. Good, good, good. All right, now we're ready to do some surgery. I've got my two hook tools here and here. What I'm gonna do is hook one end of the rubber band around this hook. The only reason I use the hooks is it makes it easier to stretch the rubber band through the bottle. So here we go. The piece of rubber band I have sticking out is really short, but using this little hooked piece of stiff wire, I can thread the wire through the bottle and right into the bottle. And now I can grab this piece of wire and pull the rubber band. Now I'm gonna take my other hook and put it through the top loop of the rubber band. This just extends that side so I can drop the penny weight into the bottle. Perfect. Now, as you can see, I've got the penny. I've got the pennies taped to the rubber band, and I can pull the rubber band through both holes. Let's go ahead and put the lid on the top. Because of this nice paperclip hook, I can thread it right through, and then I can use the hook to pull the rubber band out the other end. Ooh, I need some more paper clips. Let me go grab some real quick. See you soon. All right, I'm back. I forgot that you need two more paper clips, and these are to stop the rubber band from popping back in. And here's how you do that. If you can see, I'm pulling this rubber band up through the lid just far enough that I can slip a paper clip through. Perfect. Now I can remove the hook, and this end of the rubber band won't fly through the lid because this paper clip won't fit through that hole. Perfect. Okay, now I'm going to pull the other end through the hole in the bottom of the bottle. Perfect. Okay, so I'm just gonna hold this. I hope you can see that little gap there. It is through that gap that I want to slip another paper clip, and that will stop the rubber band from going back in through the hole. The rubber band is in tension right now. It really wants to compress back together. There it is. Wow, the weight isn't really in the middle, but that probably won't make a difference. So here's what's going to happen. When I push the bottle away, the weight will keep the rubber band from turning with the bottle, so the band will wind up, become twisted, forcing the polymer strands it's made up of to extend lengthwise down the band against the constant effects of thermal motion. Now, the force this requires will take momentum away from the rolling bottle, whittling it away with the help of things like friction and air resistance until the bottle has zero forward momentum. The kinking and shortening effect of thermal motion will continue though, now rotating the bottle backwards until the band has unwound enough that the torque it exerts due to thermal motion shortening its polymers returns to zero or just becomes too small to turn the bottle. It's a simple thing, but I love this. And it really was one of the first little scientific curiosities I ever built. I must have been single digits old, and I loved it. All thanks to the Bill Nye Fan Club subscription box. In a lot of ways, I hope the curiosity box can achieve the same excitement in people's minds that that subscription did for me when I was young. I don't know how long it lasted. I feel like I only got maybe two or three of them, but that's all it took. I still have the rollback bottle that I made when I was younger, and it's at my mom's house. I'm so sad that I didn't pick it up when I was there for the holidays, because you could have seen the exact thing that got me so excited about hands-on science. So go ahead and make your own. You can use any device or a bottle or can that you want. I really like using an opaque cylinder because it's hard to see how it works. Also because it's larger, and because the weight I'm using in there is a 9-volt battery, I think it's a little bit slower, which is pretty cool. I think it looks more ghostly. This one also rolls straighter than this one because the weight is more in the middle. You can, you know, finesse that and fix it however you want. So there you go. Rubber bands are fantastic. And things that roll back because of the behavior of rubber bands are really fun and almost a little bit magic. So go build your own, have fun, and as always, thanks for watching.
Oats are the tasty treats that are haunted and wet. Yum!